time, time is the thing we all want, and when we have it, we don't know what to do with it. True or true? Welcome to my YouTube channel Ugly Truth Superhero. Today is about honest ugly truth about time, time values, and time management. Does time has a value? A short story, one day a man asked Saint Peter. Saint Peter is the one who keeps the keys of the gates of heaven, written in Bible, Book of Matthew, 16:19. Saint Peter, how much value is worth 1 second? Asked the man. 1,000 years, Peter said. And how much money values $1? Here in heaven $1 values $1,000,000. Could you please, give me $1? Yes, but wait a second. The man was sad, he needs to wait 1,000 years. What is the value of time? You already know the example with the kid who asked his dad, how much money he is paid for a working hour. Dad said $10, the kid takes $10 from his savings, his piggy bank, and give them to his father so he can play 1 hour with him. The real ugly truth is that we don't value time due its importance and priorities. We say we don't have 1 hour to go to gym every day, but we spend 2 hours on YouTube, daily. We said we don't have time for family, for playing, but we watch television every night. We are complaining that our workplace eats all of our time, but we don't want to make changes and manage time in a different way, or change the job or learn how to invest money, to put money at work for us, not us working for money. The things that everyone on the planet agree about time is that time is money, relative, on my side, ticking, an illusion, running out, the enemy, is now and time's up. In some countries people want to work, to make more money and a better living, in other places, super tired people want to stay home with family and do other things, relax. The ugly truth is that we want to make more money with less time spent at work. In the past, it was a sunny day, I offer a translating service and made in 2 hours, half a salary, the best deal ever, theoretically, 4 working hours in a month, a salary. Another ugly truth fact is that rich people calculate times in momentum, in moments, in memories, and little quality time spent with family. They do things that many of us can't afford, visit places and they pay big prices for things we can't afford and we don't need. They don't have enough time, because they make money, they manage money. Rich people evaluate on other criteria the time and its importance. Rich people calculate time and things using cost per hour, price in dollars, cost per employee or cost per service. The poor people and some of normal people appreciate time in quantity. How many hours or days I can stay with family, playing, dancing, cooking, simple things that we do together. We go to work, take the salary and go home, that's it, the money we receive are enough or not. But we are happy in our social status present conditions. Poor people calculate things in cost per time. If I want to do this, it will cost me 10 hours, or half an hour. Makes sense? The baseline about time and money, and if you have some financial education about how money work, is to calculate things both sides. Example, if a thing or service costs me $20 or a day of work, I choose to pay $20 and have a free day. Everyone can externalize some things that costs too much time. I know people who use public transport, or taxi, instead of buying a car. They have enough money even to hire a driver, they don't need a car. Or they decide to live minimalist way, because less things means less managing time and more time for other things. The children don't have the notion of time. They calculate it in days and years, in time spent for playing. A child visited for a month his grandmother at her farm, but he was sad because he was not with his friends. His grandmother in the 10th day say to his nephew, "Today you will go home, the month has passed." The child was happy. Elderly people calculate time in days, Thank you God for another day. In the Bible, in Psalm 90, is written, Teach us to number our days, that we may gain a heart of wisdom. Or in Psalm 84, Better is one day in your courts than a thousand elsewhere, I would rather be a doorkeeper in the house of my God than dwell in the tents of the wicked. This verse refers to the importance of going to church and have a community. Another fact is number 86,400 seconds in a day, what we do with them, is at our choice. Nobody live them instead of us, even if we work or you're a stay-home mom, the time is ours. If you optimize your daily program and save 1 hour a day, you stay on internet just 1 hour, instead of 2 hours, in a month you save 30 hours and in a year you save 365 hours of working for your personal project. This is math plus time management. The brain is connected to time, because time is like a wicked behavior, a vice. For example, we must know in every moment, what time is it? How many times a day you watch at a clock and think, I have 3 hours, until I go home, until my favorite movie begins, until I will meet my girl/boyfriend, until I will eat. We have watch on the cell phone, on a wall, the smart watch on the hand, in the car, on the street intersection, on the computer or television. My way is to work and do the things by not watching or knowing every time, what time is. When I worked outside I look at the sun and know approximately what time is it, I don't have a smart watch. I must, and you must not be so desperate about time, must relax in having a good time management and life management. In Bible, Proverbs chapter 6 is written, a little sleep, a little slumber, a little folding of the hands to rest and poverty will come on you like a thief and scarcity like an armed man. The ugly truth about time, biggest, superhero, the ugliest thing is that no matter how smart or less smart we are, how much time we have or we don't have, how much time we dream to have or we sleep. The ugly fact is that we spend time, as we want it. We can make time rolling. We change the priorities in the task we must to, we spend time as we want it, but time is a true and honest friend, if we have a deadline to learn a thing, or do something, a project, and if you don't calculate the work time, you will not have enough time to finish the project. Or if you live paycheck to paycheck, and you don't calculate the money you have, at the end of the salary, when you spend all of it. You remain with 10 days until the next salary, 10 days with no money left, and you must borrow other. The debt is the gasoline that makes you work every day, and motivates you, if you are in debt you don't have many choices. What to do with time? I have 14 years of non-stop working, at two working places, and in the past when I had 3 months of staying home between the jobs, I stayed 3 months with no activity. I was like a lion in a cage, almost gone mad, didn't know what to do with time, I made some volunteer work, I was like a working robot who was plugged out from electricity. What is time? Like I said in the episode Ugly Truth Future Jobs, link in description. I want to work, not here, not now, not this, not for this salary, not so much time, not with this boss. Not this responsibility, not so hard. This is the job trap. The trend and temptation is to become lazy, to procrastinate and delay things, to increase the lack of motivation, if you have time and money. What is the driving force of doing things if you already have the basic needs, food, sex, and entertainment, enough money and time? What is the ugly truth? The honest thing that motivates you to be a good time manager. When is the moment we realize that the time is moving and we are behind him? When we finish school, when all the people around us are getting married and we don't. When we are tired of working. When we become aware of the importance of time in our life. Time is the wisest counselor of all, time heals a wounded soul, time is a problem solver and a good advisor. A best friend and a traitor in the most beautiful moments of our life, like a blink of an eye. Love having time. I know a man who works as a watchman and stair cleaner, 300 to 350 hours on a month. The job he is doing is not hard or exhausting. He work for money. Other people work 40 hours for those money. We have this paradox, this debate. I work all time and I don't have time to make money. And the other side, I make money. I don't have time to be an employee of someone. Many times we use time as an excuse when we don't want something, or to do something, or to be somewhere. I don't have time, we say, instead of being honest and say, I don't like you, I don't want to do this, I think it's stupid. In hard days, the time is delaying. A day with much work to do, or problems, is like three normal days. A day full of happiness, activities, and joyful moments, is like 2 hours. It's already the end of the day. In the Psalm 90, is written, our days may come to 70 years or 80, if our strength endures, yet the best of them are but trouble and sorrow, for they quickly pass, and we fly away. Time, money, time, money, time, this is the battle of our life, the ticking clock of our lifetime. In these years when we have the option of working to make money, and the option of staying home with family or do other things together, we must choose every time between family or goals, hobbies, free time, and work, how much we work. We sell our time to the highest bidder, you sell it to the person who offers the most money for it, your boss or employer or a customer. Or you buy time, paying other people to do the things you cannot do, or you don't want to do in order to have more personal time. In the end of this episode, I remembered a video about the lifetime of an insect. The insect was born in the morning of the day. In the middle of the day he found a female insect and made eggs and enjoyed the flowers, and at the end of the day, both of them died. Life, time, money, moments, love, honestly, what is important? When the price is time, you must cut or stop your activities and give time. When it is an opportunity to make money, make money. Thank you.